Probably like that, it's 4 minutes.
Turn off. Friends, college. We're gathered to remember one of our finest, some Willetts GC. And it's very poignant this time that the very things that we were fighting then, 1979, are still besetting us now in terms of terror. St. Willetts was one of the first of our number to die by the bomb, and we've taken ourselves along with very strange places to try and fight off terrorism. So a couple of days ago, not far from where I was born, where my family is now, came as a bit of a shock that somebody could still be evil enough to murder young kids at the start of their lives for no good reason, justified in some strange way. However, I think before we remember the man, we should remember the most recent occasion and what it was that he was fighting. Sergeant Michael Willetts, GC, remains a beacon of sacrifice in these troubled times. Awarded posthumously for an unsurpassed and selfless act of bravery at the Springfield Road Police Station on the 25th of May 1971, the George Cross is the highest British award for bravery when the enemy is not present. It is equal in status to the Victoria Cross. It is a civil award with which any civilian can be decorated, as well as the military, such as bomb disposal personnel. The citation records that Sergeant Willetts, working at the rear of the police station, was alerted by the RUC desk officer to a suitcase bomb thrown down in the reception hall of the station. He ran to the scene and took control of the clearing of the front hall of the station, ushering out police and civilian women and children from a bomb to the burning street, holding the door for their escape to a passageway. He realised that the door would not protect them and placed his body against it to shield them. The bomb detonated, blew the door apart, and mortally wounded Sergeant Willetts as his body took the blast from the shrapnel. By so doing, he spared those sheltering in the room behind from death and serious injury. Amongst them, women and children. Many more British Armed Forces personnel were to die from the bomb and bullet, but undoubtedly, this selfless act of premeditated courage by Sergeant Willetts set a standard which British-inspired soldiers and most subsequently through the years of occupation. His body received full military honours and passed the Springfield Road on the gun carriage. A plaque subsequently placed at the old Springfield Road police station was faithfully touched by the IUC as they passed it on the way to the soldiers. The soldiers' song. Counts of his sacrifice and bravery, and he is remembered among fellow soldiers in the Palace Park Memorial Gardens, Northern Ireland, where it is recorded by General Hugh Price, "A greater love hath no man than this, as a man laid down his life for his friend." However, cold courage to take on a situation not of his own duty, fully aware of the risk and the consequences. When those threatened, not his comrades nor even his friends, takes his actions to much higher plane of sacrifice.
They shall grow not old, as we the car left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
When you go home, tell them of us, and say, for you tomorrow, we gave our today.
Thank you.
are going out and are coming in our rising up and in our going down, through all our days and all our nights, until the dawn when the sun of righteousness shall arise with healings in his wings for the peoples of the world. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. I invite you to join me in saying together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Stand up there.
Order! Stand up!